This particular airplane was built by the Vandersall brothers, Denver, Colorado, in 1911. We believe they built it from plans because it's not exactly dimension-wise as the original French Bleriot. It's been pretty much kept in storage or museum its whole life. The tachometer is a period tachometer. It's called a chronograph tachometer. It works like a clock. The oil pressure gauge appears to be out of a very early car, and it works great. And that's pretty much the gauges that it has on board, an oil pressure gauge and a tach. The grade A cotton, aircraft grade cotton, has not been produced, to my knowledge, for probably 30 years, and especially the 90-inch wide fabric that we have here. This particular fabric was what they used in 1911. It was what all the early aircraft were covered up probably through the late 50s until the modern Dacron type fabrics came along. The engine is a Vandersall built engine because Denver, Colorado, the original French engine of 22 horse obviously wasn't going to work. So they built this larger engine. We're not sure what they used for the crankcase, obviously an automotive engine. But they built the cylinders and the cylinder heads, intake manifold. They built all that themselves, built the propeller portion of it, the crankshaft portion. We replicated most of those parts for reliability and safety because we want to fly the airplane, you know, a lot, we hope. The airplane being a wing warp airplane and also a very early airplane, 1911, its control response is minimal at best. A flight in this airplane, a flight of probably 15 minutes would be a pretty decent flight. It was a labor of love to put it back. Anything we did to the airplane had to be 1911. You know, we had to keep it in that category. Everything had to be 1911. The tires, the wheels, the dope, the fabric, everything had to be preserved as that era. Well, to restore something like this, for me, it was fantastic to have a job like this, to put something back. It's going to be back in the air, you know, something that was first flew in 1911, and to get to fly it again, a real airplane, I mean, that's very, very special.